In this video, I'm going to go over 7 high growth stocks you're going to want to take a look at this week. Every single Sunday on the channel, we go over stocks to keep your eye on over the upcoming trading week. And these are companies who are going to share their latest earnings, companies with a new product launch, or any big major event or acquisition that's going to drive the share price even higher or lower over the upcoming week. And in this video, we have 7 different companies, mainly within the tech sector for the market. We have some cloud names and some different software brands that have seen tremendous growth over the past 12 months that all share their latest earnings results. So in this week's video, we have some companies where even if they post a strong quarter, we may still see share prices decline. Going back a few weeks, the major tech brands like Amazon, Apple, Facebook all crushed analyst expectations. Every single one of them beat on revenue and earnings per share guidance, but we still saw their share prices decline more than 5, 6, 7% the day the announcement was made. So for these fast growth tech stocks, even if they post a strong quarter, the market's been very volatile as of late, we may see a decline in share price, making a nice buying opportunity. So for this video today, we're going to go over the 7 different companies, take a look at their current financial position, take a look at the future growth rates for the company, and take a quick peek at their income statement, just to see how fast the company is expanding year over year. So if you're new here, everyone, I am the Gen Z investor. I post a video every single day on this channel about the stock market. We go over different stocks you can buy and sell within your own personal portfolios. And every single Sunday, we go over companies to watch for the upcoming trading week. So please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel for daily videos about the market, and we're going to get right into today's list. The first company that reports earnings this week that we're going to take a look at is one of the brands that has seen tremendous benefit because of the pandemic, and that, of course, is Zoom Video. This is the new number one used form of communication, and with remote work here to stay, Zoom Video will continue to have growing revenues year over year. We will never go back to a time and place where every single person was working in the office. Remote work is a new part of our daily lives that will be here forever. And Zoom Video has capitalized on that very well, and they have seen insane share price growth over the past year, up over 536%. So they trade at a very high valuation at 187 forward PE with a market cap of 134 billion. So this is a company that reports on November 30th after market close. We're expecting a revenue estimate of just under 700 million and earnings per share estimate of 76 cents. And over the past 90 days, analysts have only been bullish on this earnings report. We've seen 24 upward revisions for earnings per share estimates and not one single downward revision. So they keep boosting up their expectations for this latest quarter. And you can see over the past 4 quarters, Zoom has beaten every single time, and they absolutely crushed the last quarter, beating by 47 cents. And this year's quarter, we're expecting 744% year-over-year growth, followed by consecutive quarters of massive growth once again. So this is a company that has been expanding at a massive rate. You can see here, year over year, revenue has been more than doubling each year. 150 million up to over 300, up to over 600, and up to 1.3 plus billion in the past 12 months of total revenue. And if we take a look at the bottom line, net income number is positive, and they have earned more than 230 million of net income over the past 12 months. And moving forward, even if the pandemic gets controlled, gets more like safe, and it's people can actually return to office buildings, we will never see them fully packed at full capacity like they once were. And Zoom Video is a company that other analysts believe will be around for a long period of time. And if we take a look at their future growth estimates, Yahoo Finance analysts are expecting more than 38% growth over the next 5 years per year. So over each and every year over the next 5 years, we're expecting more than 38% growth from Zoom Video. So this is one of the companies that I think is going to have a strong quarter. I think all 3 of these months have been in the heart of the pandemic. We fully transitioned into remote work, and I think they will be able to beat these analyst expectations. But even on a strong quarter, if there is a dip in share price to a more reasonable valuation for the company, it may be a company that might be worth a look at for your portfolio. If we move on to second stock on today's list, we have Salesforce. They are up over 53% this year, and they have a market cap of 225 billion. They've made recent news headlines as of late because they are in talks to announce an acquisition of Slack. And if they are able to get this done, we're expecting this announcement over this upcoming week, which is one of the reasons why they're included in this list. This is a major acquisition that can really help set the company forward. And as the Wall Street Journal has said, this could really help them compete with the major market leader in Microsoft. So if we take a look at what they're expecting to report, they share their earnings after market close on December 1st. We're expecting revenue of $5.25 billion and earnings per share of 75 cents. Over the past four quarters, you can see four consecutive beats. And on this year's quarter, we're expecting revenue to be and earnings per share to be flat. Barely any movement compared to the previous year, but I think that might be another beat on expectations for Salesforce. Taking a look at their income statement, year over year, big, big revenue increases. Taking a look at the chart, very nice exponential growth in total revenue. And at the bottom line, this company is profitable, bringing in over $2.3 billion of net income over the past 12 months. And going over future expectations, we're expecting more than 16% annual growth over the next 5 years for Salesforce. It is recommended as a buy right now, and the next 12-month price target sees shares at around $281, so nice significant upside potential in share price movement from where we sit today at that $247 mark. Moving on to stock number three, we have CrowdStrike. This is a company that trades around $150 per share. They were at more than 168% on the one-year chart and have a market cap at around $33 billion. So this company is a cybersecurity firm. With our new way of technology, the new way of doing business completely online, the cloud growing in demand, this company offers more than 11 different cloud modules on their Falcon platform that provide different security measures for your business. They actually operate in a subscription-based revenue model, which I am a big fan of. I like that consistent and predictable monthly cash flow coming in. And of course, they offer many different products as the threats to cybersecurity continue to increase. This is a company where their services are only going to grow in demand moving forward. If we take a look for their earnings and expectations, they report after market close on December 2nd, we're expecting $0 earnings per share. So no net loss, no profit for earnings per share. We're expecting zero. And you can see that is on a revenue estimate of $214 million. And over the past 90 days, analysts have had a bullish perspective. We've seen 17 increases in earnings per share estimates and no downward revisions. And if we take a look over the previous four quarters, they've beaten each and every time, posting positive earnings per share over two consecutive quarters. And this year, we're expecting a 100% year-over-year increase on this third quarter. And if we take a look at their income statement, they continue to expand at a nice rate. 2018, they had $118 million of revenue, up to around $250 million, $480 million, up to over $654 million in total revenue over the past 12 months. And moving forward, analysts are expecting 25% year-over-year growth within CrowdStrike. It is rated as a buy right now, coming in at a 1.9. So the cybersecurity firm may be a nice addition to your portfolio. It's definitely an interesting company to take a look at. They are trading at a rapid high valuation right now, but this is one of the companies where if you believe in this brand, the cybersecurity space is only going to grow moving forward, and they have the potential to be a leader in that industry if they can continue to expand right now when they're still a smaller company. Moving on to stock number four, we have another major cloud-based company that has seen an 80% growth rate over the past 12 months, and that is Okta. And this is one of the companies that Jim Cramer put on his must-buy list for 2020. This is one of the companies that he sees growing and expanding at a massive rate over the next calendar year, and they currently trade at a market cap of $30 billion. If you haven't heard of this company before, they are a cloud-based company that uses Okta Identity Cloud, and it's a platform of products that help you manage and secure user identities. So this is a cloud-based system of record to help store and secure user data, user application data, you know, different device and application profiles within the cloud space. So overall, this is a company where, once again, similar trend. You like to buy companies in growing industries as the, where the market and consumer behavior is trending. And as more people create more online accounts, spend more of their money, use more online accounts for every single day type of purchases, you know, all the different registries, everything is done online and less pen on paper. This is a brand that will help use that cloud-based security system, that cloud-based identity management system to help, you know, control that, and only is expected to grow moving forward. And if we take a look, you can see they report earnings after market close on December 2nd, revenue expectation of $203 million with only a 1 cent earnings per share loss over the past quarter, 19 upward revisions, and only one single downward movement for the earnings per share estimates. And you can see they've beaten over the past four quarters, and we're expecting 85% year-over-year growth over this latest report. Taking a look, total revenue continues to expand at a massive rate. $85 million, doubled to $160, up to $256, $400, $580, and over $700 million of total revenue in the past 12 months. Analysts still expecting high amounts of growth from this company currently have 25% annual expected growth from Okta over the next 5 years. The next stock we're going to take a look at is a little bit different than the first four we've already examined. And next is ticker TD, the Toronto Dominion Bank. Currently trading around $54 per share, they are down 5% on the one-year chart and have a market cap at around $100 billion. And up in Canada, they have some of the strongest financial system in the world. They have around 4 to 5 different banks that have an oligopoly over the market and dominate the entire country. And TD Bank is one of the companies that is one of the leaders in Canada. It is the second largest bank, but they actually generate 40% of their revenue from the United States. So they're nicely diversified between two countries. And this is another company that has seen and will report their earnings on this week. Pre-market on December 3rd, we're expecting it with revenue of over $7.3 billion and earnings per share of around a dollar. And if we take a look, they currently yield 4.23%. They only pay out around 60% of their earnings as a dividend, and they grow their dividend at an average rate of around 8% per year over the past 5 years. So a nice high over 4% starting yield with some beautiful dividend growth. This is actually a nice financial company that may be worth the addition into your own personal portfolios. And from this type of company, we're expecting over 7.4% annual growth each and every year over the next 5 years, which is a nice growth rate to see from a large financial institution. And if we take a look, the current price sits at $54, but the average analyst price expectation sits all the way up over $64. So a nice significant upside potential over the next year if they can hit this average analyst price target. On to number 6, we are back to the high growth tech stocks, and we have ticker DOCU, DocuSign. This is a company similar to Zoom Video that has absolutely expanded over the new work from home environment. With people no longer having in-person meetings, with people no longer sharing pens and passing a pen around a table, this is a company that has benefited extremely well and shares are up more than 216%. They currently trade at a market cap around $42 billion, and again, another company with very low earnings as of late, but still trade at a crazy high 393 forward PE. If we take a look, they report after market close on December 3rd, revenue expectation of $360 million, and earnings per share of 13 cents. Over the past 4 quarters, they've beaten analyst expectations each and every time, and they're up more than 22% year over year. And over the next 4 quarters into the future, we continue to expect massive year over year growth. At their income statement, you can see, similar to all the other tech giants on this list, each and every year we see significant beats on total revenue numbers, and we like to see that massive growth, and they are just over $1.16 billion of total revenue in the past 12 months, and net income still is negative, but hopefully very soon they can post some positive earnings over an entire calendar year. Moving forward, we're expecting more than 31% annual growth from DocuSign over the next 5 years, and overall, the price target for this company over the short term sits at around $250 per share, so nice upside from where they currently sit at $226. Moving on to stock number 7, the final company we're going to take a look at today, it is ticker DG, the Dollar General. Currently trading around $218 per share, they are up more than 37% this year, and as the overall economy suffers through some hardship, as we still have some high unemployment, these low-cost retailers are expected to benefit. They have a market cap at around $54 billion, and this is a company right now that reports earnings on December 3rd. We're expecting revenue of over $8.1 billion, earnings per share at $1.95, and of course, very bullish over this quarter, 12 upward revisions. And moving forward, over the past 4 quarters, you can see they've beaten each and every time, and we're expecting 37% year-over-year growth. Moving over, you can see from their income statement, total revenue continues to grow, not at a massive rate like we saw from the young tech firms, but each and every year they beat the previous year's number, and over the past 12 months, over $31.2 billion of total revenue. They do play out a slight 0.66% dividend yield, but their payout ratio is only 14%, so overall we're not worried about a dividend cut coming anytime soon from Dollar General. And moving forward, we're expecting more than 14% annual growth from this company, and they have a significant little upside potential over the next 5 years. So those were seven different companies that you should take a look at right now. Over the next week, we're getting some massive earnings reports that I believe will lead to some volatility in the market. We have some of the largest and fastest growing tech names such as Zoom Video, DocuSign, CrowdStrike over the next report coming over the next few days. So please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. I appreciate you tuning in and watching. See you in tomorrow's video.